the children. Well, from our last session, we are dealing with the electricity. Electricity is a convenient and controllable form of energy. So we have studied the simple circuits and the ohms law related to this simple circuit, that is V is equal to IR. Right? Here we use a load, one single resistance. But if we have a combination of resistances, like different electrical gadgets connected, so what will be the resistance of that combination? That we study in today's session. That is combination of resistors. So any electrical, all the electrical gadgets have got the resistance in them. So we can consider the resistors in them. Control the current in the electrical gadgets. So those resistors, if we can consider it a combination, then what will be the resistance? Let us study it. So there are two combinations of the resistors. One is series combination and another is parallel combination. Series combination means when the resistors are connected end to end. So this is a symbol for resistor, like this. This is symbol for resistor. So I consider three resistors, say R1, R2 and R3. Their resistances are R1, R2 and R3. So three resistors are there and their resistance is R1, R2 and R3. This is a combination of series. In this combination, the current through the combination I remains same. So wherever you consider this ammeter in the circuit, right? Wherever you consider the ammeter, that reading will be same. So the second point, I is same throughout the circuit. Next, parallel combination. In parallel combination, the resistors R1, R2 and R3, these resistors are connected together between the two points, say X and Y. They are connected together. This first end, the first end of the all the resistors are connected to one end. The second end is connected to the another point, say Y. But it's not here in this series connection. The first terminal, the second terminal of this R1 is connected to first terminal and second terminal of R2 is connected to first terminal, like this. End to end connection is called series and connected together between the two points is called parallel combination of resistors. In this parallel combination, see the current flowing through the circuit will it is divided in the three branches. We call it as branch current. Say here, say maybe I1, I2 and I3. Right? Like this. The current will be divided in the three branches. But the potential difference remains the same. Means across these ends of the resistor, across the point X and Y, if we connect the voltmeter, which is the instrument to measure the potential difference, that is simple voltage. If we connect this, then for all the three resistors, the potential difference V is common, the same. So here, V remains same. So in series, current is same. In parallel combination, voltage remains same. Let us see in series combination, what will be the effective resistance? When I said current remains the same, whereas voltage, the potential difference across this, say R1, maybe V1, let me consider as V1, across that resistance R2, say V2, and across the resistance R3, you say V. Right? So the total voltage Let me consider this as B only. Let me write this B1 in terms of our current and resistance. So current, say I, is flowing through the coil. So for this B1 can be written as I into R1 plus B2 can be written as I into R2. V3 can be written as I into R3. So if I take I common, then R1 plus R2 plus R2. This is the equation 1. Let me consider the equation 1. So we can consider here, we can consider the equivalent circuit. Equivalent means the resistance which represents the combination of the resistors. Right? Here one single resistor which represents the combination of this resistors. So let me draw this. Okay, this is a single resistor. Right? This single resistor represents the combination of the resistors. Right? So this single resistor is called equivalent resistance. Since this is a series combination, let me consider it as RS. So for this equivalent resistance, the Ohm's law is V is equal to I R S for this equivalent resistance. So let me call this an equation 2. So from 1 and 2, V is same, right? The potential difference across this combination is say V. Right? So this from 1 and 2 we can write I R S is equal to I R1 plus R2 plus R3. Right? I get cancelled, same. So we get R S is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. This is the equivalent resistance when the resistors are connected in series. So look at this. The equivalent resistance when the resistors are in series is simply the sum of the resistance, individual resistance. Equivalent resistance is equal to sum of individual resistances. Suppose say this R1 is say 2 ohm, R2 is say 3 ohm, and R3 is say 1 ohm, right? 2 ohm, 3 ohm and 1 ohm. So what will be the total equivalent resistance here? 2 plus 3 plus 1, which is 6. So always remember, in series combination, the equivalent resistance is greater than individual resistances. Right? It means when you consider different electrical instruments in series combination, then the combinations of resistance will be greater. Clear? Then let us derive the expression for parallel combination of resistance. So here I told V remains same across the ends of the connectors X and Y, whereas I is divided. So I consider I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Here I took V equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3, right? But here in parallel combination of constant, I is equals to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So using Ohm's law, V is equals to IR, using this relation, I can be written as V by R. Send this V R here. So I is equals to V by R. So I is equals to, let me write I1 in terms of V and R. V is same. V. So V by, for the first branch, I1, for the first branch resistance is say R. This is R1. And for the second branch, I2 is V by R2. For the third, I3. For the third, I3 is V divided by R. So if we take v common, if we take v common, then I will be equals to 1 by, sorry, v common 1 by r1 plus 1 by r2 plus 1 by r3. Okay, let me call this as equation 1. Again, for this, if I consider equivalent resistance, means the entire combination of this resistors is replaced by a single resistor. So in this case, it is Rp, right? Means Rp is a single resistance which represents the combination, parallel combination, right? So for that single resistance, equivalent resistance, right? Applying Ohm's law, we can write I is equal to V by Rp. Call this as equation 2. So from equation 1 and 2, we can write, see, I is saying current. So here total current. Current is saying I. So left hand side is equal. So right hand side, if we equate, then we get V by Rp is equal to V 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Right? If we get cancel, then we get 1 by Rp is equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So this is the equivalent resistance when the resistors are connected in parallel. Means the reciprocal of equivalent resistance, is equals to sum of reciprocals of individual resistance. Okay, the reciprocal of equivalent resistance in parallel combination is equal to sum of reciprocal of individual resistance. So in this case, the resistance equivalent resistance Rp is less than the individual resistors. Yeah. So if we have the different type of electrical instruments, gadgets, then it's better to go for parallel series of combination where the equivalent resistance is less than individual resistors. So is that clear with the series and parallel? So series combination, end to end combination, parallel combination connected together between two points, common points x and y, right? In series combination, current is same throughout the circuit. In parallel combination, potential difference is same between the ends, right? In series combination, the equivalent resistance Rs is equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. In parallel combination, the equivalent resistance is the reciprocal of equivalent resistance equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Here Rs is equals to, Rs is greater than, means equivalent resistance is greater than individual resistances. Here Rp is less than individual resistances. This is the difference between series and parallel combination of resistors. So if you have only two resistors, then 1 by Rp is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. If you simplify, you get Rp is equals to R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. If we have two resistors connected in parallel, then equivalent resistance is simply the product of the two resistors and sum of the two resistors. Like if we have only two resistors, R1 and R2, like this. If you have only two resistors, you can easily find the equivalent resistance as product of the two. That is, Rp is equals to product of the two. It means 2 into 3, that is 6, divided by sum of the two. Means 2 plus 3, which is 5. So like this. This gives you 1.2 ohms. See, 1.2 is less than 2 and less than 3. Means equivalent resistance is less than individual resistance. So remember this. This may be asked for the examination. The parallel combination, when R1 and R2 are in parallel combination, then the equivalent resistance is R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Sometimes they will, R1 plus R2 divided by R1 into R2, like that. They may give the options. Right? So remember, it is product divided by sum.
Into hour, 1 hour in 1 hour, you have 300,
3600 seconds. So this is equal to 3.6 into 10 to the power of 6 watt watt seconds. Right, watt second. Or energy is measured in terms of joules. So this also can be written as 3.6 into 10 to the power of 6 joules. So this is a unit. This is called electric unit. So this is about electricity chapter. So you have studied Ohm's law here, combinations of resistors and electric power. Thank you.